Hello, dear students. Welcome to this presentation. Today, we are going to talk about related word forms. We are going to use or talk about the use of related word forms to gain cohesion. Okay, first of all, it's important to remember that cohesion is necessary when we are writing because it shows that the ideas are logically related among them. So in a well-written text, the ideas are cohesive. That means that they fit together clearly, and the reader can see that connection. The reader can see that they are logically related. So in this case, one way to gain cohesion is the use of related word forms. So they are important because these word forms help the reader move smoothly from one idea to the next. And it helps the writing to be fluent and to be easy to be read. In this case, we have a paragraph showing how we can use related word forms. In this case, in the paragraph, we have some people are surprised when they learn of this unique custom because they expect the people of Southern Germany to follow the rules of the Catholic religion, which teach that it is wrong for unmarried women to become pregnant. But the windowy custom is only one example of the surprising views of marriage that are found around the world, even among people whose religious beliefs require more common marriage practices. So this paragraph refers to a very special custom. It is the windowing custom in one of the cultures around the world, specifically in Southern Germany. So as you can see, we have the use of surprised and surprising, which are related word forms, even though the word is not the same word, but they are related. So the repetition, but conscious repetition of those words, even though they are not the same, but refer to, but are very similar, it is important in order to gain cohesion. And also we have the words religion and religious. So they are also related and they help the reader to find the logical order of the paragraph in this case. We also have the words unmarried and marriage. We have unmarried women and marriage, so they are also related. Related word forms are important because they help the writer keep the reader's focus on the main idea. When the writer is designing, when the writer is preparing the paragraphs or the essays, he knows what words are related. He tries to use them adequately in order to help the reader focus on the main idea without repeating. This case, the writer doesn't have to repeat the same exact word again and again, but he can use a related word. For example, we can use a verb and we can use a noun from the same verb, but it depends on which is the correct word I want to use according to my context also and the kind of sentence I am writing. I can use the corresponding adjective, or I can use the antonym or of the same word, or I can use an adverb. It depends. So in this example, we have other pregnant women believe that they are quite beautiful during pregnancy. Their beauty comes from the joy of becoming a mother. There is a light in their eyes. and their skin shines beautifully. So we have in this example the three words that are related. We have beautiful, beauty, and beautifully. So in this case, we have in the first place, we have beautiful, the adjective. Then we have beauty, a related word for this adjective, which is a noun, beauty. So, and then we have beautifully, which is the adverb. So, we have the three words which are related in the same paragraph. We have the adjective here, we have the noun, and we have the adverb. Other examples here we have of related word forms. We could use, for example, verbs, speak, speaks, speaking, spoken, speaker. We have the verb, but another form of the same verb. And then we have in the gerund form, well, we have in the past participle, and then we have a noun. So they are related and they can be used in the same paragraph. And they will help the writer gain cohesion in his or her paragraph. Then we have work, works, working, worked, worker. So as you can see, we have the verbs, we have nouns, or it depends on the idea we want to express, and they all help us to gain cohesion. Then we have family, familiar, unfamiliar, familiarity, and familiarize. We have here a noun, and we have also adjectives, we have verb, so they can be combined. We have also familiar and unfamiliar, we have the antonym of the word, so they can be used in this way, and they will help the writer connect the words and show that logical order among them. And then we have happy, happily, happiness, happier, unhappy. We have adjective, we have the opposite, the antonym, we have the noun, we have a comparative form here, we have an adverb here. So it depends on the writer, it depends on the person who is designing or preparing the ideas, the way he or she will decide to connect them logically. Okay, another example here includes: last week, my sister got engaged. The surprising thing is that she is 6 years younger than I am. I'm not married. I don't even have a boyfriend. Marriage is an important thing, and I'm afraid my sister is making a mistake. She isn't similar to the guy at all. Their only similarity is that they both work at the same restaurant. My friends tell me I am just jealous, but I think this is a bad idea. So here we have again an example in which we have the words married and marriage. We have similar and similarity. So in this paragraph, as you can see, we can see the connection between the ideas because they are logically related, and we have the use of the words married, marriage, similar, similarity, which help us understand as a reader what is coming, what the paragraph, what's the main focus of the paragraph. So as a reader, it is also important to see this connection between the ideas in order to motivate us to continue reading and to help us understand and focus on the main topic of the paragraph or the passage. Okay, so thank you very much for your attention, and I hope we can have another opportunity to continue talking about writing, improving writing skills. Thank you very much.